Morrissey did this thing. He put both his hands on the table and he just went and growled, and the table shook. The Smiths to me were everything when I was growing up, and actually Johnny was one of the first people ever to recognise Oasis in before anybody had heard of us. He had he got hold of one of our demo cassettes and called me at home one afternoon. I was like, wow. And we've become obviously really close friends. I seen him on Sunday up at City, actually. He's just a wizard. He's as passionate about music now as he ever was. And as Morrissey, I was, you know, I don't know. I adore that man so much. He just truly couldn't care less about anything. And I had a night out about... it must be a good 5-6 years ago now in LA with him and Russell Brand, when Russell was living in LA. And I actually had to go to the toilet at one point because my stomach was hurting so much because he was crying. And it was on the day of Kate and William's wedding, right? And so we're sat in this bar and this American woman comes over and says to Morrissey, "I overheard you guys' accents. You must be British. I'd just like to come over and congratulate you on the wedding to Morrissey. congratulate you on the wedding of Wills and Kate." And Morrissey did this thing. He put both his hands on the table and he just went and growled, and the table shook. And I was like, of all the people in the world to come and thank for a royal wedding, you picked the most anti-royal person you could ever come across. A very funny moment.
Do you ever see Morrissey? He's quite a recluse, isn't he? Like, in terms of, you never see him in the...
I don't know him that well. I mean, I've met him, obviously, festivals and all that. I know him more through Russell. When Russell lived in LA, they were kind of quite close, so...
Yeah.
Most rock stars are recluses, I think you find. You know, there's only, like, a few of us who get out and still do our own shopping. But... he's a dude, I do love him.